refuse to lose one more vote by half a point. It's getting embarrassing.
Tell me about it. Maneuvering around your family is like walking through a minefield.
I thought you said you had Alan wrapped up.
Thought I did, too.
Well, if anything, both he and Monica were less receptive this time than they were last time. They acted like a couple ice cubes.
Hey, pal, it's your family. Go figure.
Grandfather?
Could be if he's still singing that refrain of like father, like son.
Well, we better start singing a new refrain of our own. Otherwise, all those ideas of yours for ELQ, not to mention the profits to be derived therefrom, are going to go up in smoke. So put on your thinking cap. Lucy.
Don't be too sure.
No. She's smart. She knows your proposals will make money. And she has no sentimental attachment to the family control of the company.
But she also likes to be a winner, and with two votes swinging to Edward, she might go over to what she perceives to be the winning side.
You know her pretty well.
Two-pronged attack. Target Lucy to keep her in the fold, then hit Katherine to change her mind.
Okay. Leave Katherine to me.
I'll persuade Lucy that she can keep playing ball with us and still come out a winner.
I'd say those ladies don't stand a chance. Another thought. In the parlance of his generation, Grandfather is quite taken with Katherine. If we land her, we might finally get some cooperation from him.
The pleasure of your company always makes my day. I've just scooped you, Ned.
I beg your pardon?
Katherine has just told me about a PR proposal for the hotel, which I found irresistible.
What PR proposal?
Well, you and AJ will hear about it together tomorrow at the 9:30 meeting from me.
Well, I'm looking forward to it.
Prepare to be impressed.
With Katherine's work, I'm always impressed.
You won't be disappointed. And I'll talk to you first thing right after the meeting with the rave reviews.
Thank you, Edward.
Surprise, surprise.
I adore your grandfather.
Mm-hmm. The feeling's obviously mutual.
Well, I harbor a few illusions these days. I think that Edward's interest in me, as well as your own, is predicated by the fact I have that 0.5% of ELQ sitting in my pocket.
I'm prepared to make you a rather stunning offer.
Oh, I'm sure you are. But your interest only increases my incentive to hold on to it.
Name your price.
Well, I'd like to. But you see, monetary value isn't nearly as appealing to me as just owning it.
I tried.
Yes, you certainly did. And very sweetly. Why don't you try again?
So what's this new PR proposal for the hotel?
Oh, come on. Let Edward have the pleasure and the fun of telling you himself.
Okay. Have you eaten? How about dinner? My treat.
I accept. We love
one. I'm one for three.
Why, Katherine and Ned, what a pleasant surprise.
Nice to see you.
Please, sit down.
Oh, okay.
Well, I'd love to ask you to join us, but I wouldn't want to make Damian feel uncomfortable.
We don't want to interrupt.
Oh, my. Aren't we all being so considerate?
Well, enjoy your evening.
Thank you.
Too.
You too.
Oh, boy, you two are so obvious.
Oh, I'm sorry. Katherine and I just don't get along.
No, I was referring to you and Ned. Hmm. You know, there he is over there just trying to sweet talk Katherine, and here you are with me. He wants to make sure that Katherine changes her vote, and you want to make sure that I
can tell you exactly what Damian is saying to her.
You think?
You boys are wooing with all your worth. It's a little conspiracy, isn't it?
So, we happen to have similar interests.
Similar terror in the ELQ vote. What will the next board meeting bring? Will Lucy jump ship just for the first fun of it? Will I swing to your side if you make it attractive enough?
All right. You win. I admit it.
Of course you do. May I offer a little advice? Lucy and I have one thing in common. We both enjoy being courted like this. Call us shallow, but it's a lot more interesting than cold hard cash. Here's a tip. Your real threat is Edward. He is just as good at this as either you or Damien.
So what should our strategy be?
Woo me harder, better, and more intriguingly than your grandfather.
Can you be specific?
Oh, come on. Do I have to do all the work? Use your imagination.
Well, money doesn't do it for you. Power? Romance?
I was thinking more in the lines of a change of scenery. Some place that we could go together surrounded by soft whites.
That's easy to arrange.
With the cold on our cheeks. You're a skier, aren't you? Well, so am I. I was thinking maybe we could get away to a weekend in the mountains. You know, spend our day on the slopes, our afternoons in a heated outdoor pool, evenings by the fire, nice perfect restaurants. I mean, that kind of environment, a girl might be able to be talked into anything.
Well, that sounds irresistible. But I'm afraid I have to decline.
More pressing matters to attend to, huh?
Well, every weekend for the next month is booked up with business that I just can't cancel. But a weekday? How about a weekday?
I only get one day.
Well, Katherine, a day with me will seem like a weekend with anyone else. In enjoyment, not duration.
Right. All right. Pick your day of the week.
Well, I don't bring my date book to dinners with me, but I'll check on it later.
Wonderful. I just hope that Lucy doesn't get bored in the meantime.